In this video, we'll learn how to use the Effect Controls panel in Premiere Pro. This is your go-to place for making fine-tune adjustments to your content in a sequence and even animating properties of your audio and your visuals. So first thing we need is to figure out where is the Effect Controls panel. In a lot of layouts, you'll see it alongside the source monitor, and you can get to it just by clicking on the Effect Controls tab. Now, if you don't happen to see that link to Effect Controls, sometimes it'll be in this little expansion menu, so you can click there and see if you find it. If you're still not finding it, you can always go up to Window in the menu bar and click on Effect Controls. Now, right now, we're not seeing anything in that Effect Controls panel because we need to select a clip in the timeline panel. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on this clip in my timeline, and now we can see some information that corresponds to that clip. So basically, the Effect Controls panel lists all of the effects that apply to your selected clip. And it's here we can come to make edits to some of these properties and even animate them over time. So when we click on a clip, we'll see the clip and the sequence up at the top of the Effect Controls. And then we'll see at least a few different default effects. So you'll have motion, opacity, time remapping applied to most clips. If you have a clip that has sound associated with it, you'll also see volume. We don't have sound here, so we're not going to see that. Any of these headings can be expanded down by clicking the little triangle next to them and getting into more granular options for each of those. So for example, motion has things like position and scale and rotation. Opacity lets you change the overall opacity of a clip or go in and mask off certain parts of it. And then time remapping lets you adjust the speed of a clip. So this is more or less what we'll see as the default Effect Control settings. If we ever want to add additional effects, we can find those in the Effects panel. Now, in most layouts, that's usually down in the Project panel, and we can get to it just by clicking on the Effects tab. Again, if you don't see that there, you can click the little expansion menu, see if you can get to Effects, or up in the menu bar, under Window, just click on Effects. Now, Premiere Pro has tons of effects built in. They are organized into these main categories of video and audio effects, among others. We can search through here. So just to give you an example, let's look for a horizontal flip. So I'm just typing in flip here, and that's gonna zero in on a few different options. So we can take these effects and really simply just click and drag and drop them on the clip that we want to apply them to. So I'm gonna drop this horizontal flip onto my clip that was selected, and I can see now I've flipped that background. I also see that I have an additional heading here in my Effect Controls where I can make some adjustments to that effect. Now, let's say that I'm not quite sure whether I wanna keep that or not. I can toggle on or off a clip just by clicking the little FX icon next to it. So that temporarily disables that effect. I can also completely get rid of an effect simply by selecting it and hitting delete on the keyboard. So let's look at a few different ways to use the Effect Controls panel to edit properties of a clip. We've already got our clip selected, so I can see some of the properties here. A few different options that we have for changing some of these are to find these numerical properties and just single click and type a value. So I can see here my scale is set to 121%. If I want to edit that, I can click on it. And let's say I want this to be 175%. Now I can click return on the keyboard and I see my scale has gotten bigger. Now another option I have for changing effect properties is to click and drag. This is a little bit like using a slider to control the property. So I can click on that scale number and drag either to the left or to the right while holding down my mouse button. For some of these properties, especially the ones under the motion category, I also have the option of making visual edits in my program monitor. To do that, I need to use my select tool and double click on that layer. And now I can click and drag things around. And you can see as I'm making those changes, my properties of position are updating in the Effect Controls panel. Let's go ahead and do Command Z a couple times to undo that. Some other options that you come across in the Effect Controls panel are basic things like checkboxes, drop-downs. You'll often also get the chance to draw vector shapes. So for example, if we turn our horizontal flip back on, right now Premiere is taking that entire clip and flipping the whole frame horizontally. If I wanted that flip to apply just to one part of the image, let's say I was focused on this inner tube, I could draw a mask either with the pen tool or some basic vector shapes. Let's grab this rectangular shape here. And this allows me to sort of isolate part of that clip apart from the rest and do the horizontal flip only on that subsection. And you can see once I begin to draw that vector shape, I get some additional sub-properties here. So lots of fine-tuned settings that we can do here through the Effect Controls panel. I'm going to go ahead and disable that again for now. I don't think that's quite what I want in this composition, but that's okay. The Effect Controls panel makes it really easy to make adjustments. All right, so that's an overview of using the Effect Controls panel in Premiere Pro.